In my previous video about ScanTo3D, I have promised that I will make another one in which I will show you how to use hybrid conversion to features. What this means? This means in this video I will show you how to use ScanTo3D to convert one imported mesh file using both automatic and guided creation. Also in this video I will show you how to edit your feature and end with direct SOLIDWORKS features instead of surfaces. Let's have a look. First, of course, we have to open our mesh file using ScanTo3D. As you can see, my mesh is actually damaged, which means I have to run also repair. But now I will show the different planes because I want to position this particular model. This will make it easier for me to convert directly to SOLIDWORKS, features. We start the mesh preparation wizard, and on the step with orientation, I will use numeric input because I don't have suitable matching faces, and I will move it manually so that my origin is in the center of this ring. Once I have positioned, I'm moving to the next steps, and here I would like to delete the text because this will be really hard to convert. In the next step, I'm changing the reduction amount until I have this warning, because if I don't do this, then my mesh preparation wizard won't repair my mesh file. I will exit at this point, I will hide the planes. As you can see, my mesh is already corrected, and now we can go and start the surface wizard and go to the step in which we can choose the guided creation. We start with the guided creation because this is the only way in which you can split your mesh model for two different types of conversion. We choose the faces, you can check this in my other videos, and of course we are extracting the surfaces using the tools in the surface extraction. But first I will extract just the middle part where was our text SOLIDWORKS. And I will do this because this is the one I would like to convert actually last. Once I'm ready with this step, I will just exit the surface wizard. Now I will move forward and I will start the surface wizard once again, but before this I will roll back the surfaces that are already extracted. In this case, I will start with the outer ring. Again, guided creation, no split line. Adjust the painting to minimum detail because we want it as one. I will actually even paint it completely with red. And I will move to the next step, in which I will make a revolved surface from this one. And I will end the surface wizard again. Now I will start, I will convert this directly using the sketch to a feature. First, I choose the right plane for this sketch, so I can delete this strange angled plane. Then I edit the sketch and add some dimensions and constraints so it's fixed in space, and I have also the chance to correct the dimensions if they're wrong. While we are waiting until I make all these edits, why don't you give a like to the video if you enjoy it? As you can see, this is not exactly three, so I make it three. And this I will make 1.5. And here the diameter is actually probably 60. Now I will make directly revolved boss base. What do you think about this approach? You can leave a comment under the video. And of course, I will name it outer ring so I can recognize which feature is that. Then I will start the surface wizard once again. But before this, I will delete some unnecessary meshes. It seems I have to do it like with the right button click and delete. It's not working only with the delete button. So I start again the surface wizard. And I will convert this ring again with minimum detail on the painting. Go to the next step. And of course, we have the suitable here, torus. However, again, we change the plane of the sketch. You see, it's really strange angle. We will use the front plane for this sketch. Then I will delete the revolved surface and make a revolved boss after adding dimensions and constraints to my sketch. And we delete the plane that we don't need anymore. For the next part, I prefer to build directly the sketch by myself. The reason for this is it was not converting them correctly and it's creating two different revolves, and this can be done with one. So I decided it's better and faster if I just build the sketch around them and make the revolve boss feature by myself. And of course, then we delete the unnecessary mesh, submesh. Now, the next step will be to fix the middle part, for which actually I need just the outline, not the rest. But first I will measure what's the thickness, that's 1 millimeter. Then I can delete the planar faces and just leave the outer contour as a guidance. I will start the sketch by myself again and make it coincident to what we have already. And later I will just remove the external relations and with add my dimensions here. If you want to be always up to date with my videos, subscribe for the channel. Now we can delete the sketches and the planes that we don't need. And I will make extrude balls with 1 millimeter, which was the size. Now Now, when the more simple part of our module is ready, we can go further and convert the heart itself. And here we will need automatic creation. Before that, I will delete the submeshes that I don't need anymore. And I will hide one of them so it's easier to navigate. For these ones, it's really important you don't start directly with the surface wizard. You have to start again with the mesh preparation wizard because we have an open hole in this mesh. And if you start with the surface wizard, probably you will end up with crashing SOLIDWORKS or error. Once we are on the step in which we have to decide the surface detail, eventually we should edit also the feature lines where we can delete lines or add lines, move points, until we have outer surfaces without any errors. Once we are on this step, we can just go with the next step and finish the surface wizard. If you're not happy with the result, just don't end the surface wizard and go back, like it was in my case. Then you can work again with the same mesh until you have the outer shape that you desire. Do this for the other part and anything that you need with automatic creation. And this is how we convert it. With both, using both guided creation and automatic creation, we have SOLIDWORKS features, we have also imported body, but not imported mesh. And we have editable SOLIDWORKS file. See you next time. Bye bye.